Hey, Pastor, we have another question. The question is, what is Jubilee and how does that affect the believer today?
Well, in Leviticus 25, Jubilee was God's methodology of getting the person that was in debt, okay, and owned property. Because remember, God, under the Jewish laws, would not allow you to sell your property. We see that with Naboth, with Jezebel and Ahab. He wanted that vineyard. And what did Naboth say? Hey, I can't sell it. Look, even if it's a good deal, he wanted to trade him for maybe even something better. But he knew that it was not for sale because you could lease it out, okay? So God gave them the ability to lease the land every 50 years. So let's say in year 30, you would prorate the 20 years, okay? And then after 20 years, the trumpet would sound and the property would revert back to its original ownership. Well, it's a picture of really the garden where man lost his inheritance, okay? We lost the dominion, land. Okay, we became indebted to sin and we became a slave to sin. So under the Leviticus 25, if a person had to give their property to survive, okay, they became a slave to their own property for someone else that owned it or managed it during that time. Okay, and because they had to pay a debt, and then they were enslaved until the trumpet sounded. So when Jesus in his inauguration of his ministry in Luke 4:18 stood up and he said, now remember, he was now 30 years old. He was allowed to read in the synagogue. In fact, we were there in Israel, in Nazareth, where they believe the synagogue is really a small, small place. And he turned to the book of Isaiah and he started quoting, "The Spirit of the Lord is upon me, for he has anointed me to preach the gospel to the poor, to the blind, to the brokenhearted, to the bruised, to the captive, to preach the acceptable year of the Lord." And this is why people don't make the connection. The acceptable year of the Lord is Jubilee. So what happened when the trumpet sounded? Okay, when the trumpet sounded, they were no longer in slavery. They were no longer in debt. And they got all of their land back and was made whole. Jesus said, "I've come to preach Jubilee. Everything Adam lost in the garden, I've come to restore it. I'm preaching to those that are poor. I'm going to," the Bible says, he was made poor that we could be made rich. And that rich is not just monetarily, okay? He's opened our blind eyes. He's healed our bruises. He's set the captive free, okay? And he opened the prison doors. And this is the picture of when Christ went to Calvary, we were no longer enslaved to sin. We were no longer indebted to the law or anything that we were indebted to. And God has fully restored back to us every single thing that was lost in the garden.
Awesome. Amen. Thank you.